This time of year, there is a lot of competition for the remaining nectar resources and some pollen. All the insects are getting buttoned down for winter time, and I've put entrance reducers on all of my beehives, and little wasps like this one are on the asters getting nectar. Honeybees are working the nectar. The leaves are turning. Bumblebees are working the nectar. They need those carbohydrates for when the temperatures turn cold. So we have lots of wasps around. We have yellowjackets, of course, that continually raid the honeybee hives. They're looking for nectar at this point. They're looking for honey. Any sugar resource that will give them carbohydrates to get them through winter. This is a bumblebee on an aster. And in another week or two, these asters will all have turned brown and there won't be any more resources there. So competition is high. Asters come in a variety of different colors. And you can see that the centers have turned brown. Those have all been worked over by different pollinators, including the honeybees. Some wasps, bumblebees, some flies, the leaves are turning. Of course, my chickens are roaming around digging for bugs in this field that we have adjacent to my property. These are soybeans. And there are lots of wasps, and I want you to see one wasp in particular. This wasp is after nectar. It presents no threat to honeybees or any of the other insects. What wasps and hornets need to feed their young would be protein. So this one is actually licking at the side of a trap, and I found something adjacent to this trap, and it wasn't there for the nectar. It was there for other insects, wasps, and even yellow jackets, and it was decapitating them, pulling their abdomens off, and chewing up the thorax and taking it back to its nest. And this is what I'm talking about. This is her. This is a giant European hornet. This is the largest hornet in North America. And even though she's actually in the yellowjacket family, she is a true hornet. Now, this video is not upside down. She is actually clinging to the top of a petri dish with little suction pads that she has on the bottoms of her feet. These things are a nightmare. If you're a honeybee, I have watched these fly down from an adjacent tree, and they're so large in the air. This particular one is 1.4 inches in length. That's about 35 millimeters for those of you who don't use inches. But they fly so slow through the air that they're conspicuous. And they land on a landing board of a honeybee hive full of honeybees, and they'll nab one of the honeybees and fly away. Again, they just pop off the head, pull off the abdomen, chew up the thorax, and fly it back to their nest. And these things occupy a huge football-sized, generally paper nest up in the trees, well off the ground, and hopefully well away from people. Now she's sitting extremely still. There's nothing wrong with her. She's alive. She's awake. But for some reason, when I put her in this petri dish, she just stood very still and did a little bit of toe tapping. But it's remarkable how still she was. Again, she's clinging straight upside down on a perfectly smooth surface. Now what happens at the end of the year, as we are now, we're in October, these females are going to be next year's queens. So after she collects the resources that she needs, and these are meat eaters, she will hope to winter over by herself somewhere. She's not going to be in the nest with other hornets. She will hide in an old tree log. She'll get underneath some shingles. They'll just find a place where they can be out of the weather, and then they'll hold out until spring. And in the early spring, this is what you'll see. starting a paper nest on her own, gathering cellulose from materials all around. They'll even girdle small trees as they chew up the bark to make the cellulose for their nests. So these are really interesting and large. So this is an impressive hornet. In fact, it's the only hornet in North America. These things were not native to the United States, obviously. They came here in 1840 in New York City. So, well, New York State. But they are biters. They sting. If you're near their nest, very bad idea. If they're in your house, in a wall, if they build your nest in the wall of your house, do not close up the entrance to that nest. These things have been known to find another escape route. In fact, would possibly even chew a hole directly into your house to get out. So if you spray insect killer or poison or something at the entrance of a nest when they've built it in the cavity of a structure, they will just make a new exit point and go from there. So in this video, I'm showing you the extreme details of this hornet's anatomy. If you don't already know, hornets and wasps breathe through their abdomen, as do honeybees. And that's why you constantly see the abdomen extending and contracting as it is here. And this is the female, and it is likely that she will be a queen for next year and will start an entire colony by herself. Now, again, I noticed her because she was attaching herself to the side of an insect trap, which was set out for yellowjackets. She wasn't there for the nectar that was in there to collect yellowjackets. She was there to actually catch yellowjackets and bald-faced hornets. She was grabbing them off and flying to a nearby tree, dropping their head and abdomen, and then flying off to wherever her nest is. And then either she or another one just like her was returning to that hornet trap, waiting for more hornets. Sometimes you'll even see them in spider webs. You might think that she's being trapped by a spider. For example, those big yellow and black striped garden spiders, but they're not. They fly into the webs intentionally, and they're actually nabbing other insects that have been trapped in the nest, and they're ripping them out from the web, and they're flying off of them. So they even rob spiders. Now you might ask, why don't I just kill this one off? Well, first of all, they're not that aggressive to people unless you walk right up to their nest and do something there. But if their nest is well away, you really don't have that much to worry about. They, unless you grab them, they are not out to get you. They are meat hunters. The other curious thing about them is these things hunt at night. So unlike honeybees and other flying insects that may seek shelter overnight, these things fly at night and can locate their food. And now I have it outside. What you're seeing in the dish with her is a bald-faced hornet that she grabbed and tore its head off. And I don't know of too many insects that these would not kill and prey upon. And of course, I'm just gonna open it up. Now, do you think she's gonna come out and sting my hand? No, because she's not at her nest site. She's not in a place where she needs to defend her resources or her territory. Now, if I push my finger down on her, of course she would sting me or bite me or both. But I just want you to see what an amazing hornet this really is. And this is the largest hornet in North America. When they fly, they kind of lumber through the air. And that's because they are just so big and so heavy. It takes a lot of energy for them to fly. Just trying to move it here so I can get a better shot before she takes off. Now she's grooming up a little because I've had her in this petri dish so I could get photos and make this video sequence, of course. So she's cleaning up a little before she takes off. We When you see one of these in the air, they can be spotted from way off. They're that big. It's really impressive. There she goes, off way into the up and to the right there, past that big maple tree. And that was impressive. I hope you enjoyed watching that, and I hope you enjoyed seeing a European hornet up close and personal. Thank you for watching, as always, and I hope you keep learning with us.